Chapter 10. Jesus Christ, Violet!
Gracie said cancer was contagious. I wanted to scare her.
Wash your mouth.
Cleveland? I spoke with Mr. Cleveland today. You're going over there tomorrow. He's been through all of this before, and he has knowledge that is beyond you and that is beyond me, and there's nothing further that I can do for you. You're gonna miss clarinet, but it's no big deal. You can just go next week, okay? And we changed the fitting into Thursday. Is a nice man. You know, he reminds me of my dad.
How come we never see Mrs. Cleveland?
I want you to talk to him. I want you to be polite. I want you to listen to what he says. And hopefully he can help because...
I don't want to go.
Violet, you're not handling your illness well.
Watch my hands, young lady. Here's the cancer, okay? And here's my lungs.
That it? Can I go now?
Get out.
Mm-hmm.
this is to help get to that little troublemaker there on your neck.
What does death look like to you?
What do you mean?
Have you ever been lying in your bed in the dark when your mother is asleep in her room in the house? Silent, like the world went on a trip and forgot you, and your stomach is in knots because your brain has just realized that we all die.
When I was diagnosed, sleep.
Your mother, I'm sure, with muffins in tow.
What's wrong with Mrs. Cleveland?
Time to go.
I think I might throw up.
Something, a little thank you, you know, it's a big deal when...
Thank you.
toilet.
To hate yourself?
Yes.
That's the hardest part, isn't it? It's not the disease. It's the hate. I hate myself. I'm afraid to die. And I hate myself.
I hate myself. I'm afraid to die. Talk to Mrs. Cleveland.
No. What is wrong with you?
I want to see her.
No, she's so sick, Missy. She's sicker than I am.
Why is she tied down?
What?
Is she a prisoner?
This is your last visit.
No.
No, I mean it. You go.
No.
Look, you listen to me.
Show me Mrs. Cleveland, or I will burn your house down.
Sick too?
Yes.
Come here. All the way. I want you to think about who in this world you most love, and then whisper it in my ear.
There's only my mom.
Oh. Whisper it in my ear.
I love my mom most in the world.
Now, you give me your ear. If you don't untie my hands, I'm going to kill your mother.
Forget I'm picking you up at 1 today. You shouldn't have to miss more school after us.
Okay.
Did you want to come to the funeral with me?
Hey, I've heard you're sick, and I've been kind of mean about Aiden, so just sorry.
Did your mom tell you to say that?
No. Well, kind of, but I was gonna say it anyway.
Do you love him?
I don't know.
Eva, come here. Do you love the most?